Dear students, welcome to our class on disaster management. Before we go into the class to learn a small quote, the only person in charge of your happiness and growth is yourself. The only person in charge of your happiness and growth is yourself, nobody else. The inference is known to you. So let's go into class. Actually, I wrote a book on principles and practices of agricultural disaster management. So, agricultural disaster management is so big a chapter. However, I am trying to complete this in a reasonable time. Maybe in 16 slides, it may take around 18 to 19 minutes. You please remember that. This question is going to come right in detail about weather disasters and their management. Now, all the weather elements are essential. However, when they cross certain limits, upper and lower limits, they are going to cause disasters. How? We are going to learn six small subheadings. The first one is rainfall. Rainfall is one of the major sources of water which is essential for plant growth and development. However, the same rainfall is considered abnormal under three conditions. Okay, what are those? Excess rainfall, scanty rainfall, and untimely rainfall. As far as rainfall is concerned, the total amount of rainfall in a season is not the criteria, but its well distribution over a large area is desirable. Heavy rain with short frequencies will result in floods. If 125 mm of rain is received in 2.5 hours, it is called as heavy rain. So let us go. What are the effects of excess rainfall? Excess rainfall results in movement of oxygen blocking. It results in blocking of movement of the oxygen. Now, soils with high rate of percolation are unsuitable. Heavy rains directly damage the plants, particularly during the flowering and pollination. Top layers are packed, snow and freezing rain are threats. A thick ice cover on ground tend to produce suffocation. Like this, the excess rainfall results in substantial damage to the crops. So how to manage them? By constructing multi-purpose projects, planned afforestation, keeping the field dams open, by growing flood obstructing crops. So these are the measures or management practices. The second one is the scanty rainfall. In other words, scanty rainfall is a drought. It is a synonym. Scanty rainfall is a synonym with inadequate rainfall or a drought. Drought was already discussed in rainfall chapter. The management was also discussed. The same things you are advised to learn and write in your examination. So we are not going to have any discussion on drought. Drought is a synonym with scanty rainfall. The management of drought is enough here. Let's go to untimely rains. This refers to rainfall received either too early or too late in the season, with the result that normal agricultural operations are upset. Too early rains do not permit proper preparation of seed bed. Too late rains delay the sowing. Wet spell during the flowering and harvesting results in poor fertilization. My first MSc student in agronomy worked on this. We proved it. Flowering and harvesting are highly sensitive to untimely rains. When rain occurs during the flowering, okay, the yields of sunflower are substantially reduced. This was our finding. Now, how to manage them untimely rains? Farmers shall be advised to follow the weather forecasting is one. contingency crop plans shall be made available to the needy. Now, so the first weather element is, so far we discussed the rainfall, when it is excess, when it is scanty, when it is dry, or otherwise the scanty means drought, and when it is untimely, it is abnormal. Now, so let us go to the effects of temperature. This was also discussed in the temperature, low air temperature and plant injury, how air temperature and plant injury. The same things only I have given here. So, there is no need for further explanation of effects of temperature in detail. Same things that we learned in the temperature, just the same things only are enough for you are getting good marks or 100 marks in the final exam or exam. And now a question is asked on this aspect. Same things with the heat waves. These are very harmful during the summer. These are experienced over Dakkan and central parts of India during March to May. The harmful effects include shedding of fruits, that means falling of fruits from the trees. Okay, then of course horticulture plantations are sometimes even in case of cereal crops as well. Plants drying of water resources. So it is also one of the things. Now the effects of heat waves is loss of water by evaporation from irrigation channels. The transpiration increases from plants beyond recouping levels. Plants tend to wilt. Hot winds cause shriveling effect on at the milk stage of the crop, most of the cereal crops. Just management of the heat waves is done by adopting specific agronomic practices like shelter belts, wind breaks, whatnot, and choice of varieties also play an important role. Now, so going to the third weather element. So far, we discussed about two weather elements. The first one is rainfall when it is excess, scanty, untimely. As far as temperature, when it is cold and when it is hot. Now, the third weather element is wind. Wind has its most important effects on crop production indirectly through transport of moisture and heat. This I told in the wind chapter itself. So, once again, for your benefit, I am just repeating, wind is the only weather element that carries water vapor and heat. So, when wind is absent, these two are adversely affecting the crop growth development. The beneficial effects of winds were also discussed in the wind chapter. Same things you are advised to write just for your academic interest. Moderate turbulence is essential to prevent the frost. Wind is very essential. Wind dispersal of pollen, once again I am mentioning now. So what are the harmful effects of winds? Harmful effects of the winds were also discussed in the wind chapter, where we discussed just for your academic benefit. Stunted growth is seen. High wind speeds, of course, adversely affect the phenology or shape of the orchards. Leaves become smaller or thicker. So, like this breakdown also occurs sometimes in certain types of the plants, you know, that's what. Management of high winds. The effects of wind on evaporation can be avoided by using proper method of irrigation. The damaging effect of wind can be reduced over a limited area by using shelter belts, wind breaks, whatnot. Even choice of varieties also play an important role, particularly in the high altitude or mountainous areas where strong root system, very strong, stem, we prefer, farmers prefer, okay, for high temperature, high wind. Now, so let's go to the things that we have discussed partly in the cumulonimbus when I discussed it, that is the thunderstorms, dust storms and hailstorms. When I discussed with you, the high clouds are cirrus, cirrocumulus, cirrostratus. Middle clouds are altocumulus, altostratus. Low clouds are stratocumulus, stratus, nimbostratus. But clouds with vertical development, there are two. Number one is cumulus. Number second one is the cumulonimbus. Usually, these are the most dangerous clouds as far as crops and life on the earth is concerned. The thunderstorms, the dust storms and the hailstorms are significant with reference to this one, clouds. That's why I have given a brief account of it. Now, these storms are known as a very, very local, very small area severe storms. As many as 44,000 thunderstorms occur daily on the earth. these are formed in a situation where a great deal of energy for their genesis and development is available. Now, these thunderstorms and of course dust storms are also same, and the hailstorms cause enormous damage both directly and indirectly. If dust, what are the dust storms? The dust is raised by the wind, which causes a covering of the small plants. This causes stomatal closure as well, even suffocation sometimes. Hails cause direct damage to crops by lodging, shattering of the seeds, etc. How to manage them? Management of the storms, whether it is a thunderstorm, whether it is a dust storm or hailstorm. Prevention of hails by hail suppression techniques, following forecasts of weather given by the India Meteorological Department or World Meteorological Organization. Spraying of salt on harvested paddy is that is suggested. And the fifth one, okay, of the weather element is after rainfall, temperature, wind, and just we have completed. What is that? Just completed. This is a question to you. I will ask at the end. Now the fifth one is excessive or defective insulation. Excessive solar radiation results in the rise of soil and air temperature. Defective insulation with constantly cloudy weather on one hand and constantly bright and high intensity sunshine on the other hand causes enormous damage to the cropland. Of course, they affect the pollination. Also, pollen burst occurs. How to manage the crop from defective insulation? Insulation means incoming solar radiation. I told this several times in the solar radiation chapter. How to manage them? Proper site selection, allowing air drainage, adequate water supply, priming of orchard trees, pruning of the orchard trees, spray of chemicals. These are the possible things work against the these things. Now, defective insulation. Now, after rainfall, temperature, wind, storms. Now, just completed is the question. What we completed? Defective insulation. The last one is tornado. This is a violent, destructive storm of small horizontal dimensions. A cumulonimbus cloud forms into a funnel shape with an vortex extending from the base of the storm to the surface. The whirlwind encircles a small dimension of about 500 meters. These are capable of causing severe structural and other damages. The tornadoes occurring on water are known as water spouts. The most important bit that you get in the tornadoes is upward spiral movement of air currents. That's what I have intentionally read this line just before what I said. The tornadoes occurring on the water are known as water spouts. Before that, you see the line. The violent winds associated with this abnormality are strong upward air currents. Okay, this is how to manage them. Warning in advance, precautions to protect agriculture produce, and quick removal of debris immediately after the damage. These are the management practices. Now, before I thank you for your patient hearing, once again I would like to impress upon you, the agricultural disaster management is a vast subject. Once again, I am telling at the end of the class that I am fortunate to write a book itself on this disaster management, Principles and Practices of Agricultural Disaster Management by V. Radhakrishnamurthy. This is the book I wrote for the benefit of not only agronomists or agriculture meteorologists or crop physiologists, but also for the administrators. Now, the whole book, putting into a small discussion of say 15 minutes, you know the how difficult is it. Still, I tried to give you a brief information on six major disasters. Number one, rainfall is good, but when it is excess, of course, scanty or untimely, like that temperature, like that wind, like that so and so. The last one, tornadoes also, I have explained. Please note that in your final examination, this bit is most likely to appear at the full 12 mark question. So thanking you very much. May God bless you. Before I end the class, again I am telling, this itself is a very book from Radha Krishnamurti, who is now teaching to you. Till I made my sincere effort to learn you, understanding. Now the quote, what I said, once again I am trying to impress upon. The only person in charge of your happiness and growth is yourself, nobody else. Thanking you. May God bless you.